I had a bit of an unusual childhood, so we moved around a lot. I went to 11 schools in 12 years and lived in places like Hawaii and Boston and Uganda, Arkansas, Somalia, Minnesota. And my dad was a tropical disease researcher for the first part of my childhood, and then he became an epidemiologist. My mom was a medical anthropologist. And I was pretty lucky that my dad was interested in how computing could improve public health. And so when he saw an advertisement in the back of a magazine for a kit computer that you could solder together, this was sort of at the very beginnings of the personal computer era, like maybe a year before the Apple II computer came out. I was 9 years old and kind of watched him solder it together, and I would like probably try to help but not be very helpful. So then I kind of was around computers from a very fairly young age at that time, and sort of a bit after that kind of taught myself to program. And then I actually ended up moving to Atlanta in after 10th grade. And the new high school that I went to, you had to do an internship to graduate. Mm-hmm. And so I told the person who coordinated internships that I was interested in software. I don't think she really knew what software was at that time. Mm-hmm. So she heard computers, and so she set up an internship at an insurance company where my job was going to be to load and unload tapes on a big sort of mainframe-sized tape drive. And I kind of learned about this the day before I was supposed to start, and I said, that's not really what I had in mind exactly. And so I kind of scrambled and found an internship at the Center for Disease Control in Atlanta, writing software to sort of analyze epidemiological data, some foodborne outbreak, and some epidemiologist goes and interviews everyone who was at the picnic and says, well, did you eat this? Did you eat that? Did you eat that? Oh, it turns out to be the potato salad. It's always the potato salad. So that was kind of the very first iteration of the software, and then I kind of went back for another internship, and then one of the people I was working with moved to the World Health Organization. And so after my sophomore year of college, I was kind of doing internships at CDC before that, and then I decided to go work for the World Health Organization for a couple more summers, and then a year after I graduated, and sort of produced more and more like later and later versions of this software that ultimately ended up being fairly widely adopted in the epidemiological community because it was free and available to everyone. It ended up getting translated into lots of different languages. This was sort of before the internet, so the way people would copy it is like someone would show up to teach a bunch of epidemiologists how to use this, and they would make like a bunch of diskettes that had the software on it and encourage people to then give out copies of other epidemiologists that they met. So that was sort of how that ended up happening. It was, quite fun.